Drafting old players versus drafting young players. There's a couple basic reasons why I don't want to draft old players. It's a kind of a cross-sport analysis. Let me give it to you. Look at other sports. Look at the NFL. When do running backs fall off? Age 30. When do, overall skills decline? Age 32. Now, not to say there's not great players that are great well into their old age, but they are answering to father time, and their skills are going to decline. And the reason I don't want to buy, pay for, look, I'm using it now. I want to buy on my drafting ADP. The reason I don't want to use a high pick on an old player is because I don't want to be there when he falls off the cliff. I don't want to be there for the skills decline. I don't want to be that guy holding Goldschmidt in the beginning of last season as he couldn't make contact, but he made up for it late, or Donaldson, who couldn't get healthy, or Joey Votto, who lost bat speed. I'm not interested in that. And sure, these guys will have good years. Like, I haven't owned any Nelson Cruz. I've been missing out on the bombs, but I don't care because it's going to fall off and I'm not going to be there. And another reason, old players don't recover as fast. So you got to figure everyone is injury prone in baseball. It's a long season. They play every day. They're throwing a hard stone around at each other. It could hit them. They're running around a square as opposed to a track, which is the way you run. The base could injure you. The wall could injure you. You can collide with a teammate in the outfield. You could hit the ball girl up the foul baseline. You could hit the bench that she's running on. There's a lot of chances to getting injured. And the difference, if anybody's been young and old or has been injured, is that young players recover faster. Can you believe that? They recover faster. So if everybody's going to get injured, when the old player pulls a groin or a hammy, it's 8 weeks, it's 12 weeks. He can't bounce back from that. A young player can tweak an ankle, a couple weeks, and he's back. So it's not only are they injury prone, it's the time to recovery. And the old guy is just going to absolutely kill me late. And I'll add this as a bump to the young players in season. They're getting better. They're getting better with every plate appearance. They've got the athleticism. They've got the skills, and they're learning the league. Is that young players can get better in season. They might learn and all of a sudden, oh, it clicked, and be better at the end of the season. So you're investing a little bit in them getting better. Where an old player, man, that season gets long. Oh, he's starting to get tight in the hamstrings and the wear and tear and the grind that you may actually be there for. Yeah, he started off hot, but his age decline, he just experienced it on the way out. Like people taking Charlie Blackman last year. I mean, the dude is 32. I mean, if you know bases are going away, and then when bat speed goes away, and then the swing starts to deteriorate and they can't keep up with the heat. It's just don't even get into it. Don't even get into it. And if you're looking for a surprise, if you're looking for a surprise breakout, it's a young player who busted his tail in the offseason, who added some skills, who was in the cage, who was in the weight room. And he can come back and go, oh, I broke out. I broke out. But for an old player, he's like, I maintained. I hung in there. I stayed healthy. I started eating right, and like maybe I won't get as injured. So, age decline 30, it's gonna start 32. Oh, and 34, 5, 6. You're crazy. I mean, there's a place for that. You know where I like to get my 34-year-olds. A guy's good. He gets cut because he wasn't hitting good, and then he gets hot, and or it, he's healthy for a minute. Jump on him, grab him. Sure. Like I know when to take Votto or Cano. I mean, they have their place, but don't reach, don't pay early for old players. It's not going to work. Draft young. 23, 24, 25. I mean, every year they say 27 is the magic year, the magic age. These guys could come in the league at 22, not get many plate appearances, not be serious, party, spend their money. And then slowly, I want to become more of a professional. I want to start, and that happens 25, 26, 27. You're at your physical peak, and it's a young man's game, no country for old men. And suddenly it clicks. Suddenly it clicks. Let's take Smoke, Justin Smoke of Toronto. He had a great year. He was 27. He finally pulled it together, but then everybody overpaid the next year at 28 because he's not that good. But he can still have his best season right in the middle, and that's going to happen ages 24 to 27, 28. Once you get to 30, 31, the bases are going down, the bat speed's going down. Don't do it to yourself.